whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his heaven.
Give them to Jesus. I know. a faithful friend to those who love and trust him. There's nothing too hard for my God to do. He's the mighty God, the Prince of Peace. There's no one like the Lord. Remember, there's a bomb in Gilead. Yeah. God will come through for you before the day is over, before the night is through. You will find the answer. God will come through for you. You've been praying for deliverance, but his word gives assurance. Before the day is over, God will come through for you. Before the day is over, before the night is through, is through, you before the day is over, God will come through for you. He'll come through for you.
Then we're going to have acknowledgments, whether written or spoken. Now, if you have anything that you would like to say after Michael is finished, make your way up, stand over here, and as the mic becomes available, go ahead and say what it is you'd have to say, okay? And if you see me get up while you're talking, you know you're talking to me. All right?
I was a very musical, driven person, and if you know anything about Grandma, which we're all family, everybody knew Grandma, she knew how to tap a foot, and what helped me learn the guitar when I was younger was her. When I say younger, I mean only like 7 years ago. She would start off with just a tap on the foot. That's all you get. And when you were doing something good, when she liked the music that she was hearing, she'd get a little dip, a swing in her groove. You know, she got into it. So this particular song, I was learning for myself, and when I found out how much she liked it through her groovy swing, if you will, it just made me want to learn it all the more. So indulge me. Thank you.
said, music was her life. She was dancing around the house, tapping her foot. She just full of so much love, and I loved her. She got along great with my mother. So, just want to say I loved her like she was my mother. And I have great memories of her. And I'm sure everybody in this room does too. And Michael, I never thought I'd hear Metallica in this house.
My name is Pastor Joshua Wall. I serve as the senior pastor at Tamarind Avenue, Seventh Day Adventist Church, where Sister Jer was in attendance for some time. I unfortunately was not afforded the opportunity to experience her life and her love. I'm still fairly new to the church, but that did not stop us from wanting to come and pay our tribute and our comfort and our love towards the family. And so there are some other members that did have an opportunity to experience her. And so they sent me some things to say about her. And it says that Sister Jared was a faithful, dedicated member. She constantly showed, hospitality to those around her. She always wanted to prepare food or some type of special drink for you. Now I'm going to assume that that special drink was... Michael Jackson just... She loved her family and more than anything else wanted to attend church and be safe. Nothing was more important than her and herself, her family, and her salvation. She was a precious gem of the Lord, and she definitely loved her husband. And I just want to say from that account and from what I've heard, I would most definitely assume and assure you that should our lives be prepared in faith to see the Lord, that we would definitely see her again, because she walked the earth and didn't just walk the earth in her own life, but walked the earth in the life of the Lord. And so for that, we pay our tribute, we pay our dedication, our comfort, anything that you all may need that you may not find anywhere else, please feel free to call myself, anyone from Tamarind, Pastor Dorsey is here as well, and any clergy that are in the house, counselors, leaders, we would definitely be at your aid and assistance. God bless you. Those videos were put together by my daughter-in-law, Michelle Salvera. Come on, come on. Says the obituary reading is next, and it says it's going to be done by me. But guess what? No. Aisha's going to do it. One thing I've learned is to be flexible and to be fluid. Be able to change on a dime. So Aisha, you're my dime.
Visited the sick and shut in. Cecilia also volunteered with Dorcas Society, distributing food and clothing to the less fortunate. In 2001, Cecilia's spouse and Yeti's youngest son migrated to Southern California, where her daughter Joy and family resides. Her new church became Tamarind Avenue SDA, at which time she continued to serve and witness for the Lord. Due to declining health issues, Cecilia became dependent on others for her daily activities of living and could no longer participate in church activities. Cecilia's life will be cherished forever in the lives of her beloved husband, Victor, and their children, Kenroy, Neslin, Delano, Mercedes, Joy, Carol, and Beth, daughters and sons-in-laws, and she also leaves to cherish her memory of greater than 20 grandkids and greater than 27 great-grandkids, nieces and nephews, and a host of other families and friends.
Chorus, if I do this, that means sing with me, okay? Song is great as thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Great is thy faithfulness. Praise God. I leaned over and said to Pastor, that was her favorite song, one of them. I remember when we were at the Lighthouse Tabernacle Church when Gene Andrews Jr. used to sing that. He was a young prodigy. His father played the organ all over North America. He was about 10 or 9 years old. And he used to sing that song, and all of the ladies of the church, Sister Jericho, or whatever, they would say, sing it! Sing it! And just to hear that just brought back so many memories. I'm just so thankful and honored that the family was able to call me to just be here with us. That was my very first church. 1980, I started serving there. And you know, as a pastor, I understood two things. I knew I didn't know everything, and I knew where to learn from. And that's from the senior people in the church, because they've been there a long way. And Sister Jared was one of those individuals who you can count on. And Elder Jack, they say it's Elder Jack and Sister Jack, and Sister Williams. All of those deaconesses, they took my wife and myself together, and they just helped us and just brought us through, so we didn't make those major blunders in ministry that you can do as a new pastor, where he might say, I'm the pastor. Pastor, you can't do that. You have to be humble, and you have to learn from those who teach you. And that was a beautiful way to begin ministry. And again, I'm thankful for the family to be able to be here. See, Brother Jared, my friend, I remember they sent me over to the house, Brother Jared. They sent me over there to see you. And they said, see if you can get my daddy to come to church. And I came over there and I talked to you, and I just, you know, we talked. He was doing something there. And I said, you know, we invite you to come to church, Brother Jared. And he just said, okay. He just wanted to be invited. And you know, folks, that's all it takes for us to share love, to have that smile, and just to invite. Don't assume what somebody's going to do when it comes to someone's spirituality, because you don't know what God is doing in the head, in the mind of that individual, preparing them for you to be a vessel to open the door, to knock on the door, and to give an invitation for Jesus. Shall we pray? Loving Father, again we ask that your Spirit will continually be here with us and comfort us as a family and friends as we celebrate the life of our dear Cecilia Jarrett. Bless us, we pray, to this end. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I entitled our message for this eulogy today, Precious. Precious, because surely Sister Cecilia was precious. In Psalms 116, there's a verse that I really love, and it sustains us when we have the loss of our loved ones. It says, precious in the sight of the Lord. Precious in the sight of the Lord.
The death is of his saints, of his children, his call, his redeemed.
It's precious. When you look at that word precious, that means it's of high value, it's highly esteemed, it is something that is dearly beloved. God, who is up in heaven, who is running the entire universe, takes time to know the death of his precious one, of his children. And you know, Pastor, I had to stop and think for a moment, because why wouldn't that be precious to God? Where he is the one where it tells us in Psalms 139, verse 13, that he saw us in our mother's womb. In other words, he knew us in our mother's womb before we even knew ourselves. He watches us through our lives. He sees, as he saw with Sister Cecilia, someone who would be dedicated to him, and he has guided her, empowered her, enlightened her, encouraged her. He has blessed her. He has possessed her with his Spirit. He has touched those around her and letting his love flow through her. Why wouldn't she be so?
someone who he saw in the womb of her mother and guided her through 93 years of life. I was just sitting here and just playing with a little bit of numbers. 93 years, that's 9 decades in 3 years. That's a half a century in 43 years. That's 1,116 months and some. That's 4,464 weeks. And since I couldn't get my calculator up, I couldn't get down to the days and the hours. Come on now. But you get the point. You hear what I'm saying? God gave her to us with all of that time, and you are a result of her life, of her being, of her guidance by God. The 27 plus great grand, the 20 grand. You all wouldn't be here if it wasn't her. You all came from her. Her blood runs through your veins, and the family line goes down. And if she was precious in God's sight, so are you.
Amen.
Because you are her offspring, and you have to know that her prayers for you are going to be answered in heaven by God. There's a quotation I just wanted to read to you. And that's important that we understand about mothers and grandmothers and great-grandmothers. It says, the spear of the mother may be humble, but her influence, united with the father, is as abiding as eternity. Next to God, the mother's power for good is the strongest norm on earth. Did you hear that? The relationship with a mother and her child next to God is the strongest influence on earth. The mother's influence is an unceasing influence, and if it is always on the side of right, her children's character will testify to her moral earnestness and worth. Her smile, her encouragement may be an inspiring force. She may bring sunshine to the heart of her child by a word of love, a smile of approval, a touch. When her influence is for truth, for virtue, when she is divided and guided by divine wisdom, what a power for Christ will her life be. Her influence will reach on through time into eternity. What a thought is this, that the mother's looks and words and actions bear fruit in eternity, and the salvation or the ruin of many will be the result of the influence of a mother. I am thankful that Sister Jared was a faithful mother. I am thankful that she was a God-fearing mother. I am thankful that she allowed the love of God to flow from her heart, where she could be considered not only a saint by men, but a saint by God. He said, but I didn't resurrect my mother when she died. I could have. Couldn't you?
Yes.
He's a resurrected life. He said, I didn't. I miss her. This way people know how much I care and I sympathize with them, because as you miss your mother, I miss my mother, and I have the power to bring her up. But I'm waiting for that break in the morning that we read about in our scripture reading when we looked at it here today in 1 Thessalonians 4, where it says the dead in Christ shall rise first. And my mother will be in that group too. And we will rejoice throughout the ceaseless ages of eternity. I'm waiting for my mom like you're waiting for your mind. And I just need you to do the work. And folks, we have to do the work of letting people know about the good news of Jesus Christ. Someone who can comfort us. Someone who can keep us. Someone who can forgive us. Someone who can empower us. someone who can enlighten us, and most of all, someone who saved us. Today, as we think and celebrate the life of Sister Jared, you're going to have those rainy, crying days. You're going to say, oops, let me tell Mom, call. Remembering things, coming back to your mind, with different scenes, especially when holidays come. But just remember this. She's sleeping in Jesus. And Jesus knows exactly where she is. And her prayers for you are on that altar of heaven, where she has God to keep you, where she has God to bring you back and be a sustaining force in your life. Those prayers are there. They live on. That's her influence. That's a promise of God. Isaiah 25 tells us that God is going to swallow up death in victory. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 26, and I love this. It says, the last enemy to die is going to be death. Come on, death got something coming for him. He can't get away from it. And on that day when we shall see the King burst the eastern sky in all of his glory, when we will hear the sound of the trumpet and the voice of the archangel, when the way that we know life shall be no more, when the grave shall open up and the saints from all time shall come forth, including Sister Garrett and all the faithful mothers and fathers and on throughout all of time come forth. And if we are alive, we'll be changed in an instant, in a twinkling of an eye, beholding the beauty and majesty and love of our Jesus. The Bible says we'll be caught up in the air to meet him, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. And that verse 18 of 1 Thessalonians 4, it says, comfort one another with those words. Friends, I don't have to tell you this world is going crazy. You turn on the news, you see what's happening. No values or anything. People do what they want. People say what they plead. Governments and madness. It's just a mess. And guess what? It's going to get worse. Because the Bible says that these things are just the beginning of sorrows. But if we just hold on and be faithful, do like Sister Jared and all the others that have gone before us, as Paul says, fight the good fight. Finish your course and keep the faith. For if we do that, when the King comes, we will say, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him, and he will save us. I pray that your family stays together, stay strong, and stay inside the sacred circle of God's love to be ready to meet him and family members again on that great getting up morning. This is my prayer. This is our wish. Let it be. Lord Jesus.
always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the worry, while you were the one with all the strength. Only a face without a name. I never once heard you complain. Did you ever know that you're my hero and everything I'd like to be? Well, I can fly higher than an eagle, but you are the wind beneath my wings. I was the one with all the worry, while you were the one with all the strength. Only a face without a name. I never once heard you complain. Did you ever know that you're my hero?